You know, the Terminatrix comes in all shapes and sizes. And as I found out with my ex, the Terminatrix even speaks great English, will have natural hair, will seem very feminine. Now, this is where the BT, the WT, and every other machine comes in. Truth of the matter is, women are of issue because women rarely, if ever, have to take responsibilities for any of their actions. Can I get an amen? If you're up third shift, this is for you. You people donated earlier and it was awesome. And I promised to give you guys a show later. And I did. So yes, it's 5:20 or 5:13 in the morning on the East Coast. Yes, it's 2:13 here. But we got something to talk about. And we want the world to see it. And as a matter of fact, it might get so good that I might replay it tomorrow.
To have a throwback, you know what I mean?
Like, I might wake up and play it again. Sam, I think I will. So, guys, Odyssey Media Group, what's going on? If you guys have been joining the new and improved website, and it's only going to get better, I'm working on they're working on things to get it faster. But for those of you who are enjoying the website right now, thank you. The story that I'm about to tell you, should I tell a story or should I play a song until more people come? I'm not sure which I should do. What is this? No. It'll make it hard, though, for me to find. Thank you, Senator. How are you doing, dear? What is this? Oh, that's a taxi song. All right, I'm going to play one song and then we're going to get into it. So let me see if I can play something until we get about 200 people in here. I know it's early in the morning. I shouldn't care. But let's play a little something.
Yeah. OCP. You knew it was coming, right? Right? Listen. Open up the door and let me in, dog. I'm back in the game. Still sipping on that Hen, dog, and packing that thing. When they hollin' D.O.G., girl, they saying my name. And now they call me Dick Jones, keep it simple and plain. West side till I die, you can catch me in the V.I. double with some shit that's about to bubble. Now they call me Pete Rose, cause I'm known to hustle. I bet he has sliced alone when I flex my muscle. Clear the lane, young brother, cause I'm back on the streets. This to my lame young brother. Hell yeah, we got B. You wanna be me, young player, then take the crown. But if I see you on them streets, I bet I take you down. Not like Chris Brown, but I'ma beat your ass out them frame. You try to jack me for my money, but can't stop the rain. You ain't no blood brother, nigga, keep your faggot tattoo. And when I see you, I'ma show you what it do. Now I'm back up in it, boy, and I'ma keep running like Michael Myers, boy, I'ma keep coming. I'm hell yeah, you can see it in my face, so you better do your best to keep pace, cause I'm how I'm doing, I'm straight, can't wait to be the first out the gate. Ain't gotta keep my eyes open for the fate, cause I know that they gon' hate to see this D.O.G. get. Listen, hey, I'm back in the race with new cross trainers, and since I'm back in the race, you better cross your fingers and hope I don't see that charger on 85, like John Travolta, boy, it's all just staying alive. I guess you thought they wouldn't let me out. out of jail, right? I guess you thought I wasn't gonna make bail, right? And now you scared to pick up your phone or return a text. I got you sitting at home alone like what's next? Shaking like you woke up from a bad dream. The last time I seen you, boy, you wouldn't even walk past me. But I'm good now, I'm back in the hood now. Ain't trying to clown, but I'm still wishing you would now. Sitting up in the club with a bottle of Patron. They toasting shots to a nigga cause your boy back home. And trying to build back my kingdom, dog, and I can't wait. And I know the ex gon' hate to see the D.O.G. get. I'm back up in it, boy, and I'ma keep running like Michael Myers, boy, I'ma keep coming. I'm hell yeah, you can see it in my face, so you better do your best to keep pace, cause I'm, don't be asking how I'm doing, I'm straight, can't wait to be the first out the gate. I'm, yeah, and gotta keep my eyes open for the fate, cause I know that they gon' hate to see the D.O.G. get. Listen, back in the race, dog, you can call me Tony Stewart, the way I'm running so fluid, they call me Carl Lewis, man, I'm in the race like Barack Obama, and you gon' know it by the time I hit your block this summer. I'ma do my best to try to keep it hot this summer, like the engine up in your car, how I got your mama. You can't teach your old dog new tricks, but you can get the old dog new chicks to turn new tricks. Like 45 right after he unretired, or Jesus when he arrived, I'm backing out to get mine. So if you look in my eyes, you gon' recognize how real I am. You ain't gotta like me, cause frankly, I just don't give a damn. Like I'm in the third leg of the triple crown. You knew this was coming, so I don't know why you're tripping now. I'ma keep coming, you can see it in my face. So you fake niggas better make haste. I'm back up in it, boy, and I'ma keep running like Michael Myers, boy, I'ma keep coming. I'm hell yeah, you can see it in my face. So you better do your best to keep pace, cause I'm, don't be asking how I'm doing, I'm straight. Can't wait to be the first out the gate. And gotta keep my eyes open.
Nah, you know they couldn't stop me. Nope, you know they couldn't stop me. Right back in the race, baby. Right back in your face. Yeah. OCP. Only cash pimping.
That was weird, right, Reggie?
Yeah, cause I'm.
That was weird, right? I was like, wait, what just happened? It shut off. Hello, Joseph. Hello, everyone. If you're watching this live right now at 2:19 a.m., where are you in the world? You know what? Before we get started, that may help us get up to the number we'd like to have. And thank all of you guys for clicking that like. Where are you guys at in the world? And what time is it where you are? I'm in Phoenix, Arizona, and it is 2:19 a.m. Where are you? What time is it? I think when I play it back, I'm going to let them talk to themselves in the chat room. Akali Insomniac says Nessa. Antoinette says it's 10 a.m. in the UK. Nash says it's 5:19 Florida time. JC says it's 4:20 Texas. Reggie says he's in Japan and it's 6:20 p.m. We got New Orleans in the building, Detroit in the building. Derek is in Baltimore. Chi-Town in the building, 4:20 New York in the building. SC, Indy. Daquan is in Beham. Bronx River up in his piece. Doing it to death. It says it's 5:20 Senator says it's 10:20 Houston in the building, 4:19 St. Diego is in the building. Philly in the building. Tulsa, Oklahoma is in the building. Florida's in the building. See, you guys have almost got it up to 200 just by putting out your stuff like that. People see you guys talking and they want to join in too. So how awesome is that? Thank you for everyone that have gone and subscribed to the website. People who bought the website is up, but it is not where it's supposed to be still. It is going to be faster. We got Fayetteville in here. Naples, Italy is 11:20 a.m. New York again. Wilmington, Compton, 2:21 The whole of Texas is what Danny is. Packer Girl says... It's about the, I've already had a little bit. That's why you probably can hear me talking a little bit slower. I've already had some. Marie G says, thank you for coming back. Look, I try to keep my word. If I said I'm going to come back, I'm going to come back. And earlier you guys donated, and then I was so happy that the website. They can look like they're civilized. They can sound like they're civilized. In many cases, they will even try to act like they're civilized. But deep down, the BT, the Terminatrix, or the WT, the white Terminatrix, or the SP, the SAP Terminatrix. All of these Terminatrix, they come in different languages, they come in different colors, but they all have one thing in common. They didn't do nothing. When it comes to women, there's nothing you can tell them that will make them admit there was a problem, that they were at fault. When it comes to females, there's nothing you can say to make them whole say, I'm sorry. Nothing you can do can make this whole not blame you. She ain't sorry, sorry. She'll stick to her lie like a nigga on death row. Sticking to that lie, cause that's all she knows. She telling you to your face. Bitch ain't got no taste. She's straight lying. Just lying. Nothing you could do could make them hoes stop lying. They just lying. Then you can't do nothing to stop hoes from lying. That's all they do. Every girl, they get a chance. A woman sit there and lie, man goes to jail, she won't flinch. I want you guys to tell me if you've never thought to yourself, how can a woman sleep with several men, blame it on one dude, put that dude in jail, know it ain't his baby, and still like do it with no issue? Is there anybody else that says, like I said, that's scary that you're able to do that? Is there anyone else that says, you know what? That's pretty freaking scary that you can do that. That to me is one of the deepest measures of women. That you can look and you will see the things that they do, they have no remorse over doing them. Women have sent men to jail for life and not flinch. I know people hate when I talk about women and my disdain for a lot of them. But women have way too much power and they're way too irresponsible with it. Thank you, Ken. Don't do it, Damon. You can't say women are nice people when they've put men in jail for years over lies. You can't say this. I don't care what anybody says. You cannot say that this is a nice group of people when you know that baby's not yours. When that woman came on that that news show and said after the DNA proved that that baby was not his, she would not take him off child support. She would not let this man move on with his life. He had married this woman, didn't do anything wrong. She was cheating on him, had a child with somebody else while they were married, and then decided to leave the man at when the kid was nine, then decided to tell the man who she knew the kid's father was, whom she had let keep seeing the kid the entire time. She decided to let that man be the father and take the kid away from the man she's forcing to pay, whose kid it wasn't. They spoke to the man, and his lame self said, I can't control what she does. So because she won't take him off of child support, he's stuck on child support. Can somebody tell me in what universe, in what world does this show that women are good people? In what universe, in what world would anyone believe that women are good people like they sell us, that women are these perpetual victims? Well, I don't think women are perpetual victims, but I do think they have the ability to keep victimizing over and over and over again. Packer Girl says, look at Reuben Foster's ex. She admitted she wanted to ruin his life. And how about this, Packer Girl? Bet you nothing happens. Bet you nothing happens. Let me tell you what this case is before you watch it, and I guarantee you. Well, I can't guarantee it. Here's what I'll say: everybody should be disappointed in the woman's actions, but not surprised by the woman's actions, but surprised by the woman's actions. Everybody should thank the judge for being honest and fair, but we should also give a good fuck you to the system for even listening to cases like this. This woman's 9-year-old son, I want you to hear me out. This woman's 9-year-old son took a gun and robbed a store to steal his mama a gift. Did y'all hear me? This 9-year-old boy thought it made sense to pick up a gun, go rob a store to get his mother a gift. So guess what brings us to this case? The mother is suing her ex-boyfriend. And she's suing him because she said he left the gun at her house that her son got a hold of. But my question before we play the video is, if you had a good son, what would make your son feel the need to pick up a gun because he wanted to buy you something so bad? Number one. Number two, where would he get the idea of robbing someone for money at 9? Let's play the game. Let's see where we go from here. I don't know why she's holding her head cocked over to the side like that. When this motherfucker gonna start?
Gibbons is suing Robert Irving in the amount of $1,320. Ms. Gibbons claims Mr. Irving left his firearm within reach of her son, who took it and tried to commit a crime. Mr. Irving claims it was the plaintiff's fault that her son had access to the gun.
All rise. Court is now in session. The Honorable Judge Christina Perez presiding. Please be seated. All parties have been sworn in, Your Honor.
Thank you, Bernard. Ms. Gibbons, Mr. Irving, and Mr. Gibbons. How old are you, Mr. Gibbons?
9 years old.
You're 9 years old. You're a very handsome young man.
Thank you.
Do you know why we're here today, Mr. Gibbons?
Yes. My mother's suing her boyfriend for giving me a gun, and I had to get in trouble for it because I was trying to get a gift to my mom.
All right, let's make some physical observations. The boy is cute as a button. The mom has beautiful bone structures, a beautiful shape. Very attractive woman to me. The man is very handsome, nice shave. They all are purporting and comporting themselves very, very well. I must give them an A-plus in presentation and delivery. Here's my problem. The little boy sound like a little hoe like his mama, because there's no dad around, I'm pretty sure. He sound like a little hoe like his mama. If you listen to his cadence and everything, he sounds like his mother. Number two, shouldn't we be offended that he knows so much about his mother's situation and his mother's dating habits and all of this stuff at 9? Shouldn't we be offended that no matter how well-spoken this boy is, he felt the need to go out and rob for his mom? And he sounds quite defiant at the beginning as he himself is denying culpability. Listen.
And Mr. Gibbons. How old are you, Mr. Gibbons?
9 years old.
You're 9 years old. You're a very handsome young man.
Thank you.
Do you know why we're here today, Mr. Gibbons?
Yes. My mother's suing her boyfriend for giving me a gun, and I had to get in trouble for it because I was trying to get a gift to my mom.
Wow. Okay. All right. So, is it okay that we discuss the case in front of Mr. Gibbons, or should we have him step out?
It's fine.
It's fine?
Yes.
She says it's fine. Okay. If at any point I see that we shouldn't discuss something, I will ask you to step out. Is that okay?
Okay.
Okay. So.
All right. Does anybody find a problem with what we just heard? You brought your son into this court case. The judge had to tell you. Yes, he does look like Will Smith. The judge had to tell you. Are you sure you want your kid to leave? And you said no. Because like the majority of black mothers, they subject their children to problems that are way above their age grade. He started off talking about your boyfriend. How many of you black boys found yourself knowing way more than you should, especially about mom having boyfriends? Judge is saying, you don't want to, you sure you want him to stay here? Yeah. Now listen to what she immediately starts talking about. Now the woman said, if it gets to be too much, we're going to put him out. Listen.
So, Ms. Gibbons, you dated the defendant, Mr. Irving. You are suing him for $1,320.
Correct.
Explain what happened, please.
So I am suing Bobby today for negligence. He left his firearm within reach of my 9-year-old son. My son is now entered in a juvenile diversion program, and I really feel as though Bobby should front the cost. You know, we met because he came into my nail salon. He immediately got my attention. I found him very attractive. He was charismatic, nice to all the other employees. You know, so I definitely took notice of that. Although he did come in with another woman, they didn't really seem to be getting along that well. Mm-hmm. So I took it upon myself to, you know, slip Bobby my number while she wasn't looking.
Okay.
And I mean, I don't usually do that, but the attraction was really strong. And like I said, they didn't really seem to be connecting.
All right. I want you to stop right there. Can you take him out for a second, please?
So judge says, all righty then. Let's go on and get the kid out of here because you just ain't gonna shut up. What do I tell y'all about dark-skinned women? What do I tell y'all about dark-skinned women? They will throw themselves at a motherfucker, boy. They are aggressive. You saw this man come in with another woman, gave him your number anyway, and felt like he would be a good man to bring around your child. Nia said it has nothing to do with the flesh tone. You can go ahead and keep saying that, Nia. And I'm going to keep thinking what I think. First off, by the shade of her son, you can tell whoever she let knock her up was probably that color or higher. So as I told y'all, dark-skinned chick get pregnant, she keeping it. She don't have nothing better to do with her life, she keeping it. The dumbest thing in the world. If you're in here, please click the like. The dumbest thing in the world. And now you're willing to bring a man around your son that you know came into your salon with another woman, and you wanted to see if you could take that man from that woman. Class act.
Okay, so go ahead, continue.
Yeah, so they didn't really seem to be connecting, so I took it upon myself to give Bobby my phone number. You know, a couple weeks went by, he didn't call me, so I figured, you know, maybe he wasn't interested. And then a couple days after...
A couple of weeks went by, he didn't call me, so I figured he wasn't interested. Not a couple of weeks went by, and he didn't call me, so I figured he's still with the girl he was with. How about that?
That he actually did call me. He explained to me that, you know, they weren't really getting along and that they had broken up and that he was interested in taking me out on a date. So that next day, we went to a dinner and a movie. He seemed to be the perfect guy. You know, I don't really have...
What about Mr. Gibbons? What about Luke?
He seemed to be the perfect guy. A man you got from another woman.
Luke's dad.
Luke's dad, he bailed on us. We were both very young when Luke was born.
No contact.
No contact at all. He left. He didn't give any information. He just bailed out on us.
She said he left. He didn't give any information. He bailed out on us. You guys know what that's code word for. She fucked the light-skinned dude. The light-skinned dude fucked around and came in her, but he didn't want anything to do with her pregnant ass. She don't know anything about this man. She don't know where he is. All she knew was he was light-skinned. That was enough. She had this baby. Man nowhere around. Again, listen to how she described Lucas's father.
Broken up and that he was interested in taking me out on a date. So that next day, we went to a dinner and a movie. He seemed to be the perfect guy. You know, I don't really have...
What about Mr. Gibbons? What about Luke's dad?
Luke's dad, he bailed on us. We were both very young when Luke was born.
No contact.
No contact at all. He left. He didn't give any information. He just bailed out on us.
All right.
So, you know, I'm on this first date with Bobby, and, you know, he seems like a total gentleman. You know, Luke's dad, sort of a hoodlum, some other guys in the neighborhood, you know.
Luke's dad, sort of a hoodlum. So you out in open air, let Luke know his daddy wasn't shit. Isn't it amazing how black women love to let us as boys know that they daddy ain't shit, that your daddy ain't shit? They have no problem letting you know. And with that Valley girl accent, why would she be fucking a hoodlum? With that Valley girl, I'm so educated, but you fucked a hoodlum. Well, I guess the BTs are powered by the same cell, no matter how they sound or what they look like. And somebody said, and you got another hoodlum around your son. Exactly. Exactly.
They're not really gentlemen, so it was very refreshing for me to be with someone who I thought was a good quality man.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I'm very selective.
What did you think about Miss Gibbons, Mr. Irving?
I thought she was, a nice young lady when I met her. She slipped me her number when I went to the nail salon, so she
and
was hot.
And did you know she had a child?
At first, I didn't know she had a child. But okay. After a while, like a couple months when we was dating, she brought him up, mm-hmm. which I didn't have a problem with because, you know.
How you talk to somebody for 2 months and don't know they have a kid? How you talk to somebody for 2 months, fuck them, and then find out they have a kid? How, bro? You've been fucking this woman for 2 months, and then she told you I got a kid.
I have nephews, stuff like that, so it was
okay.
Cool.
So you were fine with that?
Yeah.
Okay, and did you understand naturally that it's important for her to have a good male role model in her house?
Right. Yes, ma'am, I did. And at the age he's at, 9 years old, I thought it was essential to kind of, just trying to connect with them and just see where it goes. So I did.
So then you allowed, you felt strong enough about Mr. Irving that you allowed him and you introduced him to Luke?
Yeah, it took almost 2 months because I'm very selective with who Lucas can meet. I have to set a good example for him. So,
it took almost 2 months because I'm very selective on who Lucas can see. That ain't very selective. Alex can tell you on one hand how many chicks in her 12 years of life she've met that I'm so-called dating, and they're introduced as I'm dating this person. You brought a grown-ass man who you've known for less than 2 months around your son. You're so selective about who Lucas meets, but you weren't selective about who you had Lucas by. Now you're not you're not selective enough to care who you had Lucas around. But let her continue to dig her own grave, because she's doing an awesome job.
After about almost 2 months, I did introduce him to Bobby. Mm-hmm. And that's when I really started to fall for him, because they hit it off so well. You know, he really stepped up to the plate. You know, he started doing homework with him, taking him out to the park.
He really stepped up to the plate. Y'all see how they give you them attaboy terms when you do stuff to make to help their lives out? Men, be careful. Women use attaboy terms when you're on a suicide dummy mission. They use disparaging words when they want to knock down anything positive or good that you do. It's a game they play. And you men are so ridiculous enough to sit around and say, well, I want to get an attaboy as well. So I want to take care of this kid. I'm going to step up to the plate.
You know, I work closing shifts sometimes. So, you know, I let go of my other babysitter and Bobby started watching him.
You like Luke?
The nigga started being the babysitter. Y'all see where this is going, right? What kind of man got that kind of time to babysit your kid? One without a job. You just met this man. You took him from another woman. You've known him for a little under 2 months. He's now keeping your kid in your house alone. He's now keeping your kid in your house alone. How many times have I told you guys in the black community, the prey is introduced to the predator by the protector? I got to write that down. Let me say it again. The prey is introduced to the predator by the one that's supposed to protect him. Black women will leave their children with anyone. I've been left with several of motherfuckers, didn't know who they were. Stay here, be quiet. I'll be back later. Yep. Y'all remember when the young lady came over to my house to stay with my daughters? And her mother was like, I'll send her out there. Do y'all know I had to tell that woman, I will not have your daughter out here by herself. You can come with her. But no matter how nice you think I am, no matter how much you love my YouTube videos, no matter how sexy you think I am, your daughter's not coming to my house by herself. That's how that came about, y'all. My daughters wanted her friend to come. Her mother said, sure, she can come. I had to tell this woman, you have to come too. And she was like, well, I can't take a lot of time off work. We can only come for a few days. And I said, well, and she can only come for a few days then. So that's how they ended up coming for a few days. For me, it was for everybody's protection. I don't need somebody saying something about me that didn't happen. She don't need to have to explain one day that some old creepy ass man took away her childhood. And I don't see why these women are so eager to leave their children with men. I think what it is it's a way for them to put an extra hook in that man. Audience? Agree or disagree? One, agree. Two, disagree. I think it's to them another way of putting their hooks in that man. They have more leverage against him than he has against them, and they don't care what happens to that child. They just want an extra hook in that man, like the Hellraiser character, Pinhead. So if you try to leave them, they're going to say you're leaving us. That's why they like to get men with no job, or like this brother probably was selling dope. Because you have no reason to introduce me to your kid. Matter of fact, you should think, my kid may really like this guy. And then my kid may really like the next guy and the next guy. And I see that I'm very bad at picking guys because my kid's father was. I know I pick women horribly. That's why I do all my dirt when my daughter's not around. I don't know how to put a good woman in front of my daughter because I don't have a good woman. The best woman I know is her mom. So she needs to be around her mom. She needs to learn from her mom. She need to be around no hoe I pick because all I pick is hoes.
Yeah, I like him. Yeah, I really took on to him. He's cool. He's cool. So, I mean, we just start hanging out at the park, playing basketball, stuff like that. I really took on to him, so we kind of created a bond. It was cool.
Okay. That's good. And did you think it was dangerous, Ms. Gibbons, that you were allowing your son to create such a strong bond with a young man that you may not have a relationship with?
I mean,
because you obviously don't anymore. So,
yeah.
Is that, you know, I'm not passing judgment, but did you think that maybe that might not be a good idea?
Isn't it horrible that you have to speak to women that way? Isn't it horrible that you have to speak to women that way? I'm not passing judgment. They are grown. Why do you have to quantify or qualify what you say or preface your statement to a woman like you're talking to an infant? Have you noticed that? That's how you talk to women, like you're talking to a dadgum child.
I am not meaning to pass judgment on you.
With the name Judge right under her name.
I'm not meaning to pass judgment.
You're a judge. I don't mean to get all technical with you. Nigga, you're a technician. I am kind of assuming that's what you was gonna do.
Coming up on Justin.
I mean, looking back, I can't say that I would have done it knowing what I know now, but okay. in that moment.
So what happened? Why are we here today?
So a couple more months go by. It's been maybe like four months at this point. And he comes to my house one day, he's huffing and puffing, you know, and being the girlfriend that I am, I'm telling him, you know, calm down, babe. So as I'm kind of coaxing him to bed, you know, as he's coming down to lay with me, a gun falls out of his pants. And in that moment, I kind of, you know, jump back because I'm like, what's going on here? Like, there's a gun in my house, let alone from a man that I'm starting to fall in love with. He assures me that it's for protection only.
What kind of protection do you need, Mr. Irving?
Well, I mean, just protection in general. You know, I deal with a lot of cash hand to hand and dealing with customers face to face, being a barber at the local shop. And I leave late at night and I make the deposits at the bank because I'm the manager at the shop.
Are you licensed to have the gun?
Sure.
To carry?
Would you like to see it?
Yes, please.
Okay.
Do you carry it with you everywhere you go?
Yeah, I do carry it with me everywhere I go because, I mean, I do have the concealed and I have the license for it. So I normally keep it on me.
Okay.
When your gun is falling out your pants, you are not a responsible gun owner. Can I get an amen? He says he's a barber. We all know if you're from the hood, the barber and the mobile car detailing guy is a drug dealer. Somebody said not a drug dealer after all. Shit me. The barber and the mobile car detailer, they both sell drugs. I know. Somebody said, not always. I didn't say always. I'm not. Oh, God. I love saying that not always shit. All I'm saying is when I did it, it was a front. I did it, it was a front. And everybody I know who did it, that was a front. Sorry, it's a perfect front. They're perfect fronts. Your boy, Diddy said, I got two car washes in a barber shop. He said, I ain't going to say nothing else. Hey, Diddy, you know they sent back? I got 5 emails. I don't know if you got them, but they sent them back. I'll just say that. They sent them back. I'm just telling you. I'm not saying that you doing it. I'm not, bro. I'm just saying. When I was in Texas, y'all remember when I was filming, them dudes was my barber. The barber that I went to go get my hair cut by was straight up selling dope. While I'm in the chair, his client came in. This nigga told me, I said, hold on a minute. Went out there and straight up sold. But anyway, I just don't get how you could just, like, you're an irresponsible gun owner if your gun's falling out your pants. Period. If you got a, and she said he came home running, breathing hard, and then the gun fell out his pants. She said she was shocked. She'd never seen a gun before. And let's see what she did after that.
All right. Knowing that there's a 9-year-old little boy, did you ever tell your girlfriend that you have or you carry a weapon?
I never just came out and told her up front because we just never came up. So I didn't think it was a big deal. Me, I don't think it's a big deal because I have a license.
But, I mean, it's not a big deal when she has a 9-year-old child. What if that child would have found it?
Right, which is why I never blankly brought it around him or had it out in front of her or anything like that.
Oh, I see. So it was never with you when you were there. It just happened to be that this day you had it with you.
Right.
And previous to that, you just didn't bring it in.
No, I didn't necessarily have a need to.
All right, so then you told him you don't want him to bring a gun to the house?
I made it very clear to him, I don't want to see the gun again. You know, regardless of whatever reason why you're carrying it, that's up to you.
And did you ask for his firearm license, the permit, everything?
I did not ask to see the license. I just knew that I just didn't want to see it again. And
you didn't want to see if he was authorized to legally to carry it?
I mean, I just assumed
I would have.
Yeah. I mean, I just assumed that he was.
If you're not used to guns and your man come in breathing real hard, gun falls out. Same man who you know, you met him with a chick, took him from the chick. Why would you not investigate the purpose of this gun and if you have a license for this gun? As a matter of fact, I need to know more about who you. How much you want to bet she'd never seen any identification from this man, any government identification? How much you want to bet? Y'all have had people around y'all's children and you had no ID. My ex never seen my ID. Before I saw her, I had to see her driver's license. Anybody who's ever come to my house, I have their driver's license. Anybody that's ever come to my house, I have their driver's license, a picture of their driver's license.
Okay. But, all right. So then what happened next?
Yeah. So after telling him how I feel about it, he assured me that I would never see the gun again. And at that point, I thought, okay, well, that's the end of that. A couple weeks later, I'm doing my laundry. I'm reaching up to my normal spot to grab my jeans to go in the laundry. And I feel something that's hard and metal. I kind of look up and it's a gun. And at that point, my blood is boiling. I'm furious. I'm shaking.
So this nigga's now stashing guns in your house. She said she was washing. Somebody said, why? Because why would I let somebody in my house and I don't know who they are? I won't let anybody in my house and I don't know who they are. There's millions of dollars of equipment in here. If I let random woman come in my house, one of the best things for random woman to do is let her random friends come up in my house and random rob my ass. So he stashing guns in your house after he said, I never bring guns in your house. How you go from, this is the only time I brought a gun, to you just stash guns up in my house now. Does this sound like just a barber to y'all? Dwayne, do he sound like he just doing barber work when he's stashing guns? He don't sound like this nigga. This nigga done turned her house into a bando. He done turned the house into the bando. When he came into her salon, she gave him a number. He was like, hey, what's up? Hello. Didn't know you had a son, so I knew you was a hoe. I brought my gun and you said, don't bring it no more. The next day you saw me with one stashed up on the stove. I'm just saying.
It's the same gun?
Yes, it's the same gun. You know, I'm furious. I dropped my laundry and I call him immediately. And, you know, I just let him have it, Your Honor. I said,
did you call the police to come and pick up the gun?
No, I took the gun and I put it in my purse and then I put it away because my plan was to take it to the police the next morning.
You're going to wait till the next morning with your son in the house?
So she found the gun. She put it in her purse and said, I'm going to take it to the police the next morning. That's a damn lie. First off, she would have called him immediately. No nigga gonna think about taking a gun to the police. They're not doing that. So I'm not even gonna listen to that lie. She only repeat what the judge said. There's no way. Listen, you leave a gun at my house, I ain't calling the police. I might call you and tell you to come get this motherfucker. And don't you leave this shit at my house no more. As a matter of fact, you better not come to my house. I ain't taking it to the police, though. They arrest me. Niggas, we don't do that. I'm not handing no evidence. Soon as I hand over the evidence, I become the suspect. No. Can my fellow black men give me an amen? I get that motherfucking gun to a crackhead before I give it to a cop. I get that gun to one of them kids. I give the gun to one of them kids in the neighborhood before I give it to the cop. That's a lie to the motherfucker. I am not giving no cop no random ass gun. No. I'll get shot handing it to him. Oh yeah, I found this. Blah, 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 blah. No. Pandora says sprinkle some crack on him. Exactly. Hell no. If I had to give you a gun, I'd mail that motherfucker priority. I refuse to hand over a damn gun to a damn cop. Fuck that. That's why when they pull me over, you got any weapons in the car? Nope. I was asking what they pulled me over for, speeding? You got any weapons in the car? Nope. You pull me over speeding, give me the ticket so I get the fuck up out of here. I'm good. Tell that damn lie.
Just let him have it, Your Honor. I said,
did you call the police to come and pick up the gun?
No, I took the gun and I put it in my purse and then I put it away because my plan was to take it to the police the next morning.
You were going to wait till the next morning with your son in the house?
He wasn't there at that time.
But you were still going to leave.
See how they got an excuse for everything? All right, listen to what she said. I was going to go to the police in the morning. Oh, my son wasn't there. Cool. Let's hear more of the story then.
Leave it in your purse? I mean, not let him even come and pick it up or call
the
police?
No, I told him specifically, like,
and you at this point had no idea if he was legally authorized to carry the gun?
No, I mean,
and you
didn't
bother asking.
I assumed he was, but I did not request to see any papers.
Why did you leave the gun in her house again after she told you not to?
Well, I didn't necessarily just leave it in there. At first, I was watching babysitting Lucas.
You did necessarily leave it in there because it was there, so you left it there. So after she knew she was so upset, why would you leave it there? I mean, there's a knock.
This fool said he didn't intentionally stash a gun. How do you stash something unintentionally? Where they do that at?
Listen, you guys are adults. You can do whatever the heck you want.
Right.
But there's a 9-year-old little boy. What if he would have found it?
Yeah, which is what I was thinking. So, I mean, we're at the house.
You were thinking and you still left it there? Is that how you think to protect a 9-year-old little boy that you've gotten to care for?
Well, I mean, what happened was I put it in the closet where he couldn't get it. I brought it in the house.
Was it loaded?
It was loaded. Yeah, it's always loaded.
Okay, so what happened, Ms. Gibbons? I mean, I know what happened, but please explain.
Yeah, so I put it in my purse and put it away.
The next morning. So it wasn't important of you enough for you to call the police, to take it to him, to come and pick it up. You just left it in your purse.
Yeah, I mean, I didn't want him to come pick it back up because he was not invited.
Okay, so what happened? Your son came home.
So pretty much what happened the next morning is, prior to that, I had gone out the night before. My friend thought it was a good idea that maybe I could release some stress because my blood was literally boiling.
And where was the gun?
The gun was still in my purse. It was at home.
And where was your son?
He was with the babysitter.
At home?
Yes. So, you know, the next morning, I'm definitely a little bit tired from the night before.
Jesus.
I will admit that. And, you know, my son comes up to me. He's 9. He's energetic. He's happy. He's like, Mommy, I want to go play outside. I want to go to the market. I do allow him to play outside in the, you know, front area and the market, which is about 2 blocks away. That's as far as he can go. So when he approached me that morning saying, I want to go out, I said, sure. He says he wants to go out. I go back to sleep. And then, you know, maybe.
You see how frustrated black women and women in general. This can't be just be about black women, because women in general, that's why women will quickly tell you they don't like other women. Women in the audience, black, white, or whatever. Am I telling the truth? This is why women don't like other women, because when women talk to you, you realize how stupid they are. Come on, tell me I'm lying. Women, no matter what color they are, the reason why a lot of women say they don't like being around a lot of women is that right there. When y'all hang around other women, you realize how stupid they are. And most women are like, oh my God, seriously? You have you have a conversation with a woman and she make you slap the shit out of yourself. Girl just told me her friend got into a wreck in her car. I said, well, why was your friend driving your car? She said, I was sleepy. I said, you were sleepy? She said, yes, I was sleepy. I ain't finished. She said, I was really tired, so I let her drive. She said, but we had to switch when she got into a wreck. I had to get behind the driver's side. I said, wait a minute, what? She said, yeah, I had to get behind the driver's seat. I had to get in the driver's seat. I said, why? She said, because her license is suspended. I said, wait a minute. You let your friend drive your car a long distance knowing her license was suspended. Well, yeah. And so what happened was I didn't really see what was happening because at the time when the car wreck happened, I was texting. So I said, well, I know that you wasn't texting me. So that's another question that we'll talk about down the road, motherfucker. But right now, we just gonna keep it on what you told me. So you was in the car with her because you were too tired to drive. But when the wreck happened, you was texting. I got it. I got one. Yeah, I got one. It did it that thing where it says it'll take 2 to 3 days to clear, though. I had a girl tell me she didn't take a bath after we, you know, because it is what it is with black chicks after you. And I was like, oh my God, you don't smell that? I finally just couldn't take it. So I said, you don't smell that? She said, well, what am I supposed to do about it? I did like this. She said, I already took, I said, well, if what you smell was a problem, normally people would be like, oh, I'm so sorry. This is not, because, you know, as a woman, when you know your cat don't normally stink, when you have that day where it does stink, ladies, tell me if I'm lying. Don't you do that whole, oh, I'm so sorry. You know, my pH is off, something. Like, you explain that shit because it's not normal. Well, I got up immediately and took a shower. I was like, my God, this is some, and it smelled like shit. She said, I'm hungry. Let's go to the Waffle House. She had already put on her clothes after I got on the shower, out the shower. She didn't wash that thing or nothing. When I told her about it, she said, what do you expect me to do? I had already taken one bath before I came over. I swear to God, an adult female said that. Because I said, I immediately went and took a shower because I smelled it. You didn't. Why wouldn't you? She said, because she'd already taken one. That's what makes you just slap your damn head.
Yes. So, you know, at the next morning, I'm definitely a little...
What I want you fellas to start doing when the women have stinking ass pussy, when you lay in the bed, I want you to lift up the sheets, and you know that's when that smell hits you in the face. As soon as you do it, I want you to pull the sheets back down around your waist, set up real slow like this, and go, oh, who lives in a pineapple under the sea? Aquatic absorbent porosity. His nautical nonsense is something you wish. So get out my bitch. Get out my bed, cause bitch, you smell like fish. Ready?
Bit tired from the night before. I will admit that. And, you know, my son comes up to me. He's 9. He's energetic. He's happy. He's like, Mommy, I want to go play outside. I want to go to the market. I do allow him to play outside in the, you know, front area and the market, which is about 2 blocks away. That's as far as he can go. So when he approached me that morning saying, I want to go out, I said, sure. He says he wants to go out. I go back to sleep. And then, you know, maybe an hour afterwards,
you go back to sleep.
Yeah.
With your 9-year-old running around.
Black bitches love to do that too. Let you go outside, get raped by Wayne Williams. Oh. Wonder why Wayne Williams let you be the one to get away. You mean you ain't gonna kill me after this? No, I'm gonna let you go home. No, Wayne, no. You gonna let me go home after this? You gotta kill me, Wayne. The fuck I look like going back to the neighborhood telling them what you did?
And a gun in your purse.
I get a phone call about an hour later, and it is the police. I was blown away because they informed me that my 9-year-old son had been detained for carrying a weapon.
I'm sorry, but that lets you know you're a poor parent if your 9-year-old feels the need to go take a gun and rob someone. That lets me know the type of family you've had him around and the type of people you've had him around and the type of shows you've had him watching. And honestly, ma'am, that boy has seen you do some shit like this. There's no way a 9-year-old is that comfortable enough with a gun to go walk up in a store, point that gun at somebody and say, "Give me the loot, give me the loot." Like he Biggie Smalls.
I ran as fast as I could. I got all my clothes on. I walked and ran down to the store. You know, by that point, I was crying. Like, I apologized to the owner who was there. I apologized to the police. And I said to my son, you know, what happened? I mean, where did I go wrong? Like, what could I have done to prevent this? Like, you know, what?
Should I give you a list?
Coming up on.
I mean.
That bitch said, where did I go wrong? So where? Where did I go wrong? And who's gonna take care of my bastard son? And where did I go wrong? And who's gonna take care of my son? This is stupid. Shout out to Babyface.
I definitely made some mistakes.
Listen, I'm being hard on you, and on both of you, but you particularly. Because you seem so bright and put together and such an intelligent person. And you have completely spiraled to worse than stupidity.
I mean,
you did not act reasonably. It's beyond being reasonable. You were so careless. You were so
Now, do y'all understand why I use the words I use in the video? I don't understand why people say, how dare you be that harsh? When women know they're that harsh on other women, because women will bring out the only words you know to describe their damn actions. Use a dumbass bitch. I don't know what else to say. All that I can say, either I'm gonna call you a dumbass bitch or just go do 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 do, because that's all I can say. You better be a dumbass to sit up here and act like you didn't do anything wrong, and you really trying to tell me I need to get this man to pay for your child being on probation. You don't know what other words to use to stupid people. Can I get an amen from the audience? Dead ass. You don't know what stupid people will make you call them something. Cause you're like, no, there's no good word for this. Like, I'm not one of those people who don't believe you can't call your damn child a motherfucker or whatever it is. Now, I don't believe in just cussing your kid out, but sometimes your kid is a motherfucker. Sometimes your kid is a dumbass. If you got a 13, 14 year old, that motherfucker doing dumb shit, fucking up his life, you's a dumbass. I ain't got no good words for you, motherfucker, right now. This some dumb shit you're doing. Sit there and pity-pat and tap the kids with the nice stick. Fuck that. They being a dumbass. And if you don't tell them right from wrong, somebody in the street gonna give them a lesson into that shit. Y'all, this is the safe zone. You in the treehouse. Nobody's gonna judge you here. You know good and damn well sometimes you tell your kids, motherfucker, sit down. I'm gonna sit here arguing with you today. You're doing stupid shit. This woman was like, I don't know how else to describe the shit you're doing other than it's stupid. There's no other way to explain this shit. I would like to say something nice to your dumb ass. I've been trying to say, that's what she said. You purported yourself and you comported yourself so intelligent. What she's saying is you didn't sound like the typical dumb ass black bitch. And yet every action you have is the typical dumb ass black bitch. I'm confused.
So I'm being hard on you and on both of you, but you particularly. Because you seem so bright and put together and such an intelligent person, and you have completely spiraled to worse than stupidity. I mean,
she said worse than stupidity. Now, did you notice she basically described what I do? She said, I know it might feel like I'm just being hard on you. She said, and in a way I am, because you hold more responsibility, because you're the mom. For how many years have I been saying, well, why don't you say the same thing about the men? Why would I? You don't have a man running around, a bunch of men raising these children. I can't blame the person who isn't there. I got to blame the person who's got 100% autonomy. And I don't understand why women want you to put the blame out evenly when they fuck up. But when their child turn out to be LeBron James, they don't want to put the congratulatory bouquets out evenly. And it's all them. Even though they've never been athletic and didn't teach them how to shoot one damn ball, it's all them. That's what pisses me off. You don't want to take all that damn credit and take no blame and give no blame. The blame is supposed to be everybody else's fault. Hell no, I'm going to blame the woman because she's the one with the damn kids. So stop asking me, why don't I talk about black men? I'm not going to talk about black men. And why the fuck would the strongest, the backbone of the black community want me to blame the ankle?
I mean, you did not act reasonably. It's beyond being reasonable. You were so careless. You were so reckless. You were so selfish. Do you want me to tell you? Do you want me to give you some statistics? A child or a teen dies or is injured from guns every 30 minutes.
I mean, Your Honor, like, trust me.
Guns kill more children under five than law enforcement officers in the line of duty. I mean, this is just common sense.
Yes.
This doesn't mean anything if you're still not responsible. You don't take a gun to a house where there's a 9-year-old little impressionable boy. I mean, the only thing I can say that at least you put it in a safe place up high so he wouldn't see it.
Right.
And you took it and you put it in a place where it was reachable for your son to get. You put it in your purse instead of taking it directly to the police. Not only did you put it in your purse, you go out and you party because you have to release stress. And then your son the next day goes through your purse, picks up the gun, and goes to a store and what? Tries to hold up the store. But how can that happen?
I mean, Your Honor, trust me, if anyone doesn't want their kid to be around a gun, it's me. And I know.
Trust me, if anyone doesn't want their kid to be around a gun, it's me. Yet you dated a man who has a gun. The man was so clumsy with the gun, it fell out of his pants. To me, if I'm a woman, I wouldn't have a problem with you having a gun. But you got a gun that done fell out your motherfucking pants at my house. You can't bring that gun to my house no more. Matter of fact, I might not let you come to my house anymore because you don't have it secure. What you doing dropping guns? Then the second time when you caught the gun, what you should have did was call the police. Ladies, I bring a gun to your house one time around your kid. You tell me not to do it again. You reach up in your house the next time and you find that I have stashed a gun in your house. What would you do? If I'm a woman, I'm calling the police on your ass and having you arrested. I'm calling the police on you and having you arrested, and no matter how much I love you, you getting the fuck out. By the time you get out of jail, your toothbrush, your underwear, all that shit gone. Not because I don't love you, not because I don't care about you, not because the dick ain't good, nope. Because I have a kid. And because you were so irresponsible that the first time I saw the gun, it dropped out your pants. The next time I saw it, you got it stashed in my damn house. So that means you'll stash anything in my damn house. Somebody said the son been stealing money out of the mother's purse. Wait on it.
Well, I will admit to my mistakes, but I don't want there to be any doubt that, you know, I've really tried my best.
So how can you blame the defendant for being responsible for something that you had more control over?
Coming up.
You had a chance to get.
Has that not been my argument from day one about babies and child support? There's no reason for people to be mad at me or act like what I'm saying is not true or act like it's wrong when people sit up there and repeat so much of my damn shit. How do you? You had the ultimate control over this. You can only blame that person. You can only blame the women in a pregnancy situation when women have ultimate control. Go sit up there and blame the dudes when the woman can decide she want to be a mom at any time. When you can't even sleep with a woman without a condom if she won't allow it. And she keeps saying, why don't you blame the men?
Tried my
so
best.
How can you blame the defendant for being responsible for something that you had more control over?
Coming up.
You had a chance to get... Do you want your son to be a statistic?
No.
If that's what you want, that's exactly what you did. Because you put yourself first before your son. And for you to turn around and say he's responsible for your son's actions, how am I supposed to swallow that?
I mean, I truly...
The negligent individual here, the reckless person, because you had a chance to give the gun away. You found it. Renard, she found it. What was she supposed to do with it?
Contact the authorities.
Immediately. How embarrassing is that?
I mean...
You're his mother. You are responsible for him. You should be ashamed of yourself.
I mean...
Completely ashamed of yourself.
I mean, I definitely am. And like I said, I'll admit to my mistakes, but I truly thought that if I took the gun and put it in my...
See what she said? I'll admit to my mistakes, but I still want him to pay. I'll admit to my mistakes, but he should have to pay. So the only people who she feels have to pay for her negligence is the kid having been put on probation and the boyfriend having stashed the gun. Not her having taken the gun from a place the boy couldn't reach it to put it in her damn purse, letting him go out in the motherfucking hood and going to sleep with a gun in your purse that you were supposed to got rid of the day before, but you said you was tired, that you were supposed to got rid of the next day, but you said you couldn't because you needed to go out and blow off some steam at the club, leaving your son where? Remember, she didn't have an answer for that. She said the babysitter. What babysitter? Usually black women's babysitter is they mama. So because you need to blow off steam because you found a gun in your house, you went to the club and left your son at home. And let me ask y'all a question. Surely you know she didn't take that gun to the club with her. So if she didn't take that gun to the club with her, where was that gun? In a house. And do you really believe she had a babysitter for that kid? Remember the girl at the Waffle House who titty got shown because she was rolling around on the ground? For those who do not remember, she has a small child. She was at the club at 2:30 in the morning. This was on a weeknight. Where was her child? Because she was out with her mama and a friend.
My purse? Because he's really never gone through my purse before.
And I thought first thing in the morning.
He's really never gone through my purse before. What does that mean? Let's do the ones and twos again. One, if you believe her. If you believe or not. One, if you believe. Two, if you don't. Do you believe that that boy has not stolen something, have not been through that woman's purse? I don't either. Well, that don't even sound right. That don't even sound right. He's never done this. I want y'all to think about this. He's never done this. He goes into your purse. If he picked this thing up, it hurt his hand. It's heavy. But this is an accurate gun because it's heavier than a mug. made in Yonkers, New York. It's a Kimber. Custom made, custom grips, custom everything. T-Dizzle, baby. 45 ACP. This is what you get. This is heavy. If that boy went in your purse to get a gun, if he didn't know you had a gun, what do you think he was? Here's what we got to believe, right? Yes, it's the 9/11. 1911, sorry. If he did not know you had a gun, what does that mean he was in your purse doing? Let's just assume he didn't know she had a gun. So that means he went to her purse for another reason. Stealing. Stealing. He had been going in purses. That's what he did. There he is. Tell him I said hi. So for as well spoken as that boy, the one thing that you seem to have not done, because you said that all the dudes in the neighborhood, so that means you haven't gotten that boy out of the hood. Why are you trying to get him a new daddy?
I definitely am. And like I said, I'll admit to my mistakes, but I truly thought that if I took the gun and put it in my purse, because he's really never gone through my purse before.
And in no universe is that a logical conclusion. Listen, I'm being hard on you because you're the person that can control your son's safety. I have a lot to say to him, but at this moment it's not appropriate because the person that I'm going to reach out to, that I hope I can reach to, is you. I don't think we go far enough to protect ourselves because too many of these statistics happen every day. And you know who is getting the brunt of it? Do you want to know who's getting the brunt of it?
Who's that?
It's African American, it's Latinos. We are the ones who are the statistic. We're the statistic. And if you...
She was about to say, it's your people. I should have stopped. She said... Oh, crap. About to get fired. So she had to change the script. And my people are Latinos. So why is it that she had to say Latinos with an accent? None of the other shit she said, she speaks with zero accent. Zero accent. Why the fuck when she decided to, oh shit, I just about got in trouble. Why she became real ethnic with your blonde hair, Meghan Markle too? She became real ethnic. Listen.
I'm going to reach out to, that I hope I can reach to, is you. I don't think we go far enough to protect ourselves because too many of these statistics happen every day. And you know who is getting the brunt of it? Do you want to know who's getting the brunt of it?
Who's that?
It's African American. It's Latinos. We are.
You know who's the one doing all this bullshit? You know who's the one fucking up everybody's community? It's your people. Oh God, no. Oh. Can we run this back? I got excited, went rogue, got off script. I fucked up. Can we just take it from the top? Can you bring the little boy back out here? Let's just scrap that whole thing. Let's start over. Let's start over. Everybody on my mark and go. So help me and cut. America will be better without you niggas. So help me, so help me, so help me, and cut.
Because too many of these statistics happen every day. And you know who is getting the brunt of it? Do you want to know who's getting the brunt of it?
Who's that?
It's African American, it's Latinos. We are the ones who are the statistic. We're the statistic. And if you don't stop it, if he doesn't stop it, if I don't stop it, nobody else will. And you know what I'm going to reach out to that I hope I can reach to is you. I don't think we go far enough to protect ourselves because too many of these statistics happen every day. And you know who is getting the brunt of it? Do you want to know who's getting the brunt of it?
Who's that?
It's African American, it's Latinos. We are the ones who are the statistic. We're the statistic. And if you don't stop it, if he doesn't stop it, if I don't stop it, nobody else will. And you know what? We're just going to be statistics. Right. That's it. And Luke, when he grows up, he's going to be a statistic. Yeah. If that's what you want to happen in your life, knock yourself out.
Judge Perez's...
So the only claim I have in front of me is the plaintiff suing the defendant for negligence. I will deny that claim. Mr. Irving is not responsible for something that you had control of, and you should have immediately, the moment you discovered this man had a gun, done something about it immediately. You had the power to make the decision, the power to control the destiny. Because guess what? Your son is now a statistic. As a mother, there are just... No words to tell you how disappointed I am in another mother. So based on the evidence, I will deny your claim of $1,320. Please sit down with your son and read to him the statistics. He's 9 years old. He needs to understand what he did and that it was so wrong. Because if he thinks he could do it now, it was so easily accessible to him, he may do it in 5 years. Yeah. If you don't sit down and give him the hardcore reality that he could one day be the victim of violence, of gun violence, that you hope he is not somebody that looks to guns, that he should not even carry one, that you have to explain to him. And it's going to be your choice to figure out what his life is going to entail. Okay?
All rise.
Judge Perez has ruled in favor of the defendant. The plaintiff's claim is denied.
Judge Perez. I just got one last question for you. What type of people do you think are ruining America and making up the large majority of criminals? Don't answer that question. You don't have to answer that, Judge Perez. Well, don't answer that question, Judge Perez. Well, who do you think it is, Judge? Yeah, I know that most of them niggas, and I know they belong in jail. Your Honor, no more questions. The time to kill. I want you guys to understand. How there's so many people who feel like with women, and especially black women, that you cannot tell them the truth. You cannot be honest. You cannot say what is what. Oh, people donated. My man Thomas C. said, love you, Tommy. Keep it up. My man Roderick B. says, keep pounding, my friend. Fits and starts are precursors to something big. History has proven that many successful people had to overcome obstacles, tunnel vision, and laser-like focus. Thank you, man. Randy donated again. He said, thanks again for the late show. No problem. Thank you, Randy. Sandra jumped in and sent in a donation. Wanted to show my support and thank you for all the work that you do. Don't allow the haters to stop you. Thank you, guys. My man Big O says he cannot sign into the website. Let me see if I can get you in there now. You may have to just go and do the, like, just let it know that you're, tell it that you lost your password. I'm going to give you right now, Oliver, a new password. And then just use that when you log in. Because I think with some of you guys, it's just not letting you log back in. Because you probably have like the old cache in your computer. So it's trying to pull from the old server. Does that make sense? Like if you have your cache in there, when you put it in, it's pulling from the old server. So it just may not be recognizing it. So I'm going to reset yours. And then you use that new password that it gives you. I'm going to reset it right now. Generate password. Copy. All right, let me see if I can go ahead and get you that, Big O. Now, you have to do, bro, is just put in that password that I gave you. And anybody else, if your password isn't working, just do the whole reset of it. And you should be fine. Looks like I see a couple of people have changed their passwords. I can't use the website. Anybody, if you're having a problem logging in, just click the reset of the password. I think that works. If you're having a problem logging in, reset your password. I think that works. All right, guys, we wrap this up. Whether this is real or not, the truth of the matter is we have ultimate responsibility to try and take care of the children around us and do the best that you can to get the most that you can out of your children. Until we start taking a direct hit and feeling the pain of having our children fail, until we start to take that directly on us, nothing will change. You have to be the one willing to stand up and say, my child will succeed or fail with the tools that I give him. Imagine when you play The Legend of Zelda and things like that. If you don't put the right tools in your bag when you get to a certain place, you can't move on to the next level, right? Isn't that how these video games work? You don't have to be a big video game player or you have to recent one. The majority of these games, if you do not have the right tools, you cannot get to the next stage. Treat your children like that. If you don't give them the right tools, they will literally keep running into walls and they can't make it to the next stage. And you have to remember, your children are in a race with other human beings. It's not America holding blacks back and putting us on high grass while they're on smooth concrete. It's our beginning. It's our start. And our starts are generally terrible. And these starts are what our parents are giving us. Not America, our parents. Because our parents choose when and if we come. So we cannot blame America. We cannot blame white racism. We can't blame any of these things for why a child is put behind the eight ball. Can I get an amen? We're not denying white supremacy. I'm saying to you, we cannot blame white supremacy by the first position our children are in. That's all us. If your children are born in the hood, that's not the government's fault. That's your fault. If your children's father is a deadbeat, that's not the father's fault. That's your fault. If your children's father is black as hell, hence your child is black as hell, that's not the father's fault or the kid's fault. That's your fault. The first person making the action is at fault. If you know you're in a ditch and you can't get out, you wrong for landing that ditch, getting pregnant, having a baby, and then looking at the world saying, white supremacy got my son in the ditch. White supremacy got my baby out here in the ditch. No, that's not white supremacy. That's you. You have your child there. You. No one else. You. Yes, Pedro Sotomayor, I was recently in there. Go ahead and look up the video. I'm sorry, when was that video? 2012. What year is it? 2018. Y'all won't bring up what I said in this video, last video, the one from 2 weeks ago, the one from 2 years ago. Nope. You just keep on trying to make something ridiculous and stupid because you want to, and I don't care. Remember, you didn't look through my window to hear the story. You didn't find out something from someone else. You literally heard me and saw me. That's what doesn't make sense. This should also tell you the type of people stalking me. You didn't come to tell me what I said in this video was wrong. You didn't come to stand up for a damn thing. That's what you came to do. That's what you came to say. And that's what they all say. The same crap over and over again. But if they really cared about pedos, why have you never heard of them ever catching one pedo? They have pedos in their family, pedos in their church, pedos in their neighborhood. As a matter of fact, True Semen got a neighborhood full of pedos. You can go on that map and see it. He ain't going after them. He ain't trying to ruin them or stop them. No. But he'll get up there and, yeah, if I catch any one of you niggas for touching a kid, if I catch any one of you with that fake outrage, any man has no record of beating nobody. Man, woman, child, or pedo. But he gonna tell you, if I catch any one of you, by your logic, you must actually physically see it before you'll do something. Because you ain't done nothing. But say you hope my daughter get raped by 12 white men. Mr. A defender of women and children said he was forced to talk about my child because I said something about his wife. I hate that stupid, that just being ignorant. If I catch any one of you, how would you catch somebody doing this? The fact that you would say that lets you know that you full of shit. If I catch any one of y'all molesting a kid. Yeah, because that's how it happens. Anyway, let me not get on them and ruin a perfectly good night. We had a wonderful morning, guys. And I'm still up. I don't know what kind of weed I had. I'm still up. I might go at it again. But for now, thank you guys so much. Y'all have a good night. Yeah, y'all have a good night. What is this? can't play that, I don't think. We'll see you guys. Peace. No, I want to hear one song. Hold on a second. I want to hear a song. I don't like how they have it split up.
Gio, Sweat Sizzle boy, Sweat Sizzle, T-Dog, holla, holla, woo, and you know, this some real shit, book one. Check it out, yeah, it goes one for the money, two for the freaks, three for them niggas that be riding in them jeeps, four for them thug niggas and five for the riding on spinners and hopping out of photos. Here we go, the man with the master plan. I never ever hit the spot without the gat in hand. With real niggas that be hopping out the back of vans with more cheese than the Green Bay Packers, man. You know these chip stackers, man. Need to be in Las Vegas the way that they be stacking the papers like T-Ron Tone, Mo, Big Rock, and C. And my homies Justin and Josh, them niggas from Cali. Let's hit up the alley, up a laundry dog, and put Mo work out like Jane Fonda, dog. 95 pounds of that marijuana, dog. Out the back of my 96 Honda, dog. Hell yeah. You hear the word on the street. Hell yeah. You hear him talking about a thug and his sneak. Hell yeah. That's why Billy ain't no fucking with me. At the bar drinking straight in the sea and hollering. Hell yeah. You hear the word on the block. Hell yeah. This nigga claiming he a thug and he not. Hell yeah. That's why he took the rays up out the spot when them boys start bucking them shots and hollering. Hell yeah. You hear the word on the street. Hell yeah. You hear him talking about a thug and his sneak. Hell yeah. That's why Billy ain't no fucking with me. At the bar drinking straight in the sea and holler, hell yeah. You hear the word on the block, hell yeah. This nigga claiming he a thug and he not, hell that's yeah. That's why I took the rays up out the spot when yeah. The boys start uh-huh. Fucking them yeah. Shots and holler, hell yeah.
And when I get up on the stage, they be like, who that nigga? But by the time I grab the mic, they be like, do that nigga? Ain't you that nigga? Yeah, that's me singing, do you wanna roll with me? Ron G, and you know I'm still popping them bombs like, ooh-wee. With the heat that I pack in my palm like, ooh-wee. Need a girl on the side of my arms like, ooh-wee. Take her home and you know that it's on like, hell yeah, bitch bad with a body like, whoa. I be like, no, when I see her drop it down to the floor. Now picture you and me bumping and grinding like R. Kelly. If you're down later on, you can hit me up on my celly like Nas did and Belly. She didn't know how to act, but I was thinking I'ma hit it on the floor from the back like that there. Cause what you packing fat back there? You down with it, bitch, hell yeah.
You hear the word on the street, hell yeah. You hear him talking about a thug and it's me, hell yeah. That's why I really ain't no fucking with me. At the bar drinking straight in the sea and hollering, hell yeah. You hear the word on the block, hell this yeah. This nigga claiming he a thug and he not, hell that's yeah. Why I took the rays up at the spot when them boys start fucking them shots and hollering, hell yeah. You hear the word on the street, hell you yeah. Hear him talking about a thug and it's me, hell that's yeah. Why I really ain't no fucking with me. At the bar drinking straight in the sea and hollering, hell yeah. You hear the word on the block, hell yeah. This nigga claiming he a thug and he not, hell that's yeah. Why I took the rays up at the spot when them boys start bucking them shots and holler, hell yeah.
All right, thank you guys for another great show. Thank everyone who donated. Somebody asked, what did I think about the school shooting? That's on my website. You can go there and see that. That is up. And I think the show I did last night, I didn't get a chance to put it up. So I'm going to put it up as well. So you guys will be able to go there and check that out if you missed it. Thank you so much. Love you guys. Get some rest. I will see you when I see you. Peace.